I try to kill myself today. A bullet. Anytime I pictured suicide, I always imagined putting a bullet in my brain. Like, in a park or something. Somewhere pretty. Sometimes I'd imagine myself running a razor blade down my wrists, too. Turns out I'm too much of a pussy to do anything that hardcore.
What did you use?
Pills. Sleeping pills. I swallowed a fistful of Ambien and washed it down with vodka and waited to drift away.
And then what happened?
And then I died. Or I felt like I was dead. I found nothing, saw nothing. I got to experience the bliss of non-existence. And then that bliss was snatched away from me. After that, I panicked. I didn't know what to do, who else to turn to. So I came here.
I'm glad you did.
Do you think there was a reason I survived? That I got to come back? Do you think it was God?
It's not uncommon for people to miscalculate the dosage for these kinds of things. Sometimes the body shuts down too. It rejects the poison before it can metabolize fully. Kind of like an allergic reaction.
Even to an atheist to take the enlightenment out of attempted suicide. I'd prefer vodka.
Alcohol's not a good idea. Tell me why. Why today? Why did you choose this morning to do it?
Because this morning he broke me.
You and David had another fight.
At this point, I think it'd be more efficient to list the days we don't.
What triggered him this time?
Divorce. I finally worked up the courage to speak to a lawyer about divorce papers. So David's muttering to himself about a flight plan, getting ready for work, and I work up the nerve to tell him that I want out.
Hey, can we talk?
That it's the best thing for both of us. Next thing I know, we're both frothing at the mouth, yelling at each other.
I don't fucking need you!
My house, too!
This is my fucking house!
And then it happened. The only reason he stopped was because he realized he had to get to the airport. The perks of being married to a pilot, huh? So after he leaves, I just sit on my bedroom floor for what seems like forever. Crying. Thinking. Then I realize that I just don't have it in me anymore. To want to fight. To want anything. That's when I noticed the bottle of pills on the counter. So, what's standard protocol now? You make an official recommendation and toss my psychotic ass into a mental asylum or something, you know, for my own well-being.
Is that what you want? A referral to a psychiatric hospital?
You know that therapist thing where you answer a question with another question? I could never figure out whether I found it endearing or annoying. Until this exact moment, I find it really fucking annoying.
Help me understand something, Hannah. You were prepared to take a life. Why yours? Why not take his?
I don't understand.
Your life is just one murder away from being better.
Well, I suppose that's one way to phrase it.
I wasn't being pithy.
What's that?
A solution. Scan this card and an app downloads. Only a handful of people get to know it exists. A fortunate handful. It allows you to anonymously trade murders. Somebody takes care of your problem and you take care of theirs. All the police see is a random attack. All the police see is another case they'll never solve. Brilliant, isn't it?
Please tell me you're joking.
Are you frightened? You shouldn't be. I'm offering you a way out. I'm offering you an end to the humiliation. I'm offering you a gift. Take the card.
Stay away from me, you fucking lunatic.
When was the last time you listened to jazz? Do you remember our first session together? You told me how much you loved jazz. Classics, Ella Fitzgerald, Billie Holiday. And then you told me how much David hated it. He called it pretentious noise and dreary bullshit. So tell me something, Hannah. When was the last time you just sat in your living room, sipped a drink, and listened to jazz? See? Now that I find profoundly sad. But that is how it works. That's what monsters do. First, they suffocate your warmth, then they suffocate your passion, and then they suffocate your will. And they take everything from you, everything that matters. And in my professional opinion, Hannah, I think it's time you took something from him. I'm gonna head into the other room now. And whether or not this card is still here when I get back, I'm gonna leave up to you.
You shut the fuck up! Fuck, you crazy!
I fucking hate you!
Yeah?
You can toss after you're done. Get a burner. Then scan the card and hang back for a moment. The rest happens on autopilot. You won't be able to do anything until you upload a selfie and an ID.
You said it was anonymous.
It is. This is just a necessary part of the process.
Fuck it.
Next, you'll put in your lesser half's information. His name. Home address, work address, job schedule, Facebook, Twitter, all of it. And that's it. You're done. The game begins. If you want it to.
Who's this?
My name's Patrick. Patrick Murphy.
I work for the airline.
The airline? Is this about David? Has something happened?
I don't know how to say this. I wish I didn't have to, but there has been an incident.
What the fuck did you get me into? What the fuck did I just do?
The police were here all day,
asking me questions, taking my statement. My phone's been ringing off the hook, and I can't
stop throwing up.
I keep hoping that this is all some fucked up nightmare, that I'll just wake up.
What you're feeling right now
is normal. I've been exactly where you are.
Doubt. Fear. Regret.
But it'll soon pass. And then it's going to get worse. A lot worse. You're going to feel dread and disgust on a level you've never experienced before.
But after that,
if you allow it, that is when you will break through to the other side. On the other side, that's where you'll feel euphoria, zen. You're going to feel free. You'll see.
This is still what happens now.
Now you do your part.
Now you play the game. Every burn has a 7-day deadline, so I wouldn't waste any time if I were you.
But listen.
Whatever you do, don't turn off the phone or try to break it. If you do, your status switches to problem player, and trust me, you don't want that. Problem players get punished. Problem players get burned. You didn't do it.
I couldn't. Not yet. Not until I found out why someone somewhere wanted them burned. So I followed him, waiting to see something. Something that'd make all of this make sense. Something vile, maybe. Something unjust. Something that would make me want to pull the trigger. Something evil. But it never happened. Until today. Until just a few moments ago, as I was standing outside your door waiting to come in. That's when I realized why somebody somewhere wanted this person burned.
I don't understand. What did you realize? Who was your target?
Standing outside your door when it hit me. And I asked myself, how many of those black cards does she have? How many has she given away? How many murders has she inspired? And that's when it hit me. Why somebody somewhere wanted you burned. An anonymous mob can't just decide who gets to live and die. That's chaos. Anarchy. Evil. So, Doctor, in your professional opinion, what the fuck do you suggest we do now?